again. Yesterday morning at 2:41 a.m. at General Eisenhower's headquarters, General Jodl, the representative of the German High Command, and of Grand Admiral Dönitz, the designated head of the German state, signed the act of unconditional surrender of all German land, sea, and air forces in Europe to the Allied Expeditionary Forces and simultaneously to the Soviet High Command.
To the folks that I know, tell them I won't be long. They'll be happy to know that as you saw me go, I was singing this song.
My name is Dorothy. I am Mrs. Carroll's granny, and I'm 90 years old.
But I know we'll meet again.
I was 9, the same age as you, when the war started. Well, we knew the war was coming because we had been warned that a lot of changes were coming, and the changes did come. I lived in Aberdeen, which is far away from here, but it was at the sea, just like here. And we knew there would be problems, there might be bombing, and there would be different things in the war that we have to get used to. The first thing we had to get used to was the blackout. All the windows were covered with black cloth or black blinds so that no lights would get into the street and aeroplanes might see us.
Till the blue skies by the dark clouds fall.
The first thing, the first change I knew in the war was the fact that they wanted my school for troops. And because they were using my school, we had to get out. So we had to share a school with a grammar school. The result of that was that one lot went in the morning and the other lot went in the afternoon, 6 days a week. That was Saturday as well, except once a month we got Saturday off. One memory that has stayed with me through all these years is a night that I was in the house by myself. Now that seems strange, but my parents meant to be in the house. They had been visiting friends. I had been at a meeting. When I came back from the meeting, they couldn't get home because there was a raid going on and the police were stopping people from coming into the town. And the raid did go on and the bombs fell very close to me, almost as close as the shops are to you from the school. But I didn't know what to do, so I hid underneath the bed. Fortunately, no bomb fell on me. It did fall on the church, no distance away. We could go out in the daytime with friends anytime we liked, but only had to be daytime because there were no street lights at all. I had to go with memories of going to my guide company in the town in the pitch dark and coming home in the dark when the air raid alarm went off and planes came overhead.
Till the blue skies drive the dark clouds.
Recently, it's been difficult to get hold of some supplies. First of all, it was loo rolls, then it was pasta. I don't know what it is now. But in our day, in the wartime days, it was rationing. You were allowed so much, everyone was allowed so much, but it wasn't very much. It was one egg per person per week, and everything else was a limited amount. You collected your rations, and that was you. If you finished them up, hard luck, wait till next week. Sweets were completely rationed, and you got, I think it was 2 ounces, it was about one cake of chocolate a week you could have. And we always went to the cinema on a Saturday, and on the way we stopped to buy our sweetie ration. It was an exciting time. Now you can see on television how this virus is spreading. Every day there are bulletins telling you all about it. But we didn't have television to know what was happening. We had radio, but that was too difficult for children to understand. So the only thing we could do was go to the cinema, and then you got news bulletins telling you what was happening. In both cases, there was fear. People were afraid, people are afraid. We were afraid of bombs happening, of bombs falling, us being hurt or even killed. Now you're being afraid, people are afraid of a virus which could make them very ill indeed. So we had to be prepared, and you have to be prepared we had to know where there would be shelters for us. You have to stay at home. When it was announced that the war was over, then relief was tremendous. We could look forward to things. We could look forward to things like rationing stopping, etc. Celebrations themselves, I don't remember very much, except that I know all the street houses in the street had a Union Jack flying from it. I expect there were parades, but truthfully, I don't remember them. But the biggest thing I remember is you could go to bed to sleep. You didn't have to worry about bombs or anything else. It was over. It's important that we celebrate today. It's important that we remember all the people who gave their lives. It may seem a long time ago to you, but you wouldn't be here now if it wasn't for these people. They made a tremendous sacrifice for us all. And that sort of thing's going on all the time. Please remember.
Some sunny day.